A blessed evening to everyone, and welcome to our prayerful midweek refill. This evening's reflection will be led by the St. George's Youth. The reflection was compiled by Sister Gabrielle David and will be presented by Brother Devonte Howell. Let us pray. O God of peace, who taught us that in returning and rest we shall be saved, in quietness and confidence shall be our strength. By the might of your Spirit, lift us, we pray, to your presence, where we may be still and know that you are God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I now invite Brother Devonte to lead our reflection.
Matthew chapter 16, verses 1 to 12. Faith, the youth reflection. Father, as we recall the steadfast faith and hope in God that so many of your faithful servants have displayed, we pray that we too may follow their example and place our entire faith in your precious word. May we develop an ever-deepening trust in you, knowing that your word is faithful and true. May we be nourished by the word of God day by day and be refreshed with rivers of living water that stream into our hearts from above, so that whatsoever we do will be pleasing to the Lord and glorify his name. Amen. Good evening, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Faith, that is our topic. Faith is a vital part of any Christian's journey. There are lots of questions about faith in our journey. We ask ourselves some of them. I'll share them now. What does the word faith mean to you as a young person and as a young Christian? How do you grow in faith? How applicable are our strategies at improving faith? How can you encourage fellow youngsters to build and maintain their faith? Deep questions, but this is what we had to say. Faith means believing and trusting in God in all circumstances, as not only children, but as young Christians. To grow in faith, we must pray, because that is one of the many ways God uses to speak to us. To grow in faith, we must read our Bibles, because as we become more knowledgeable in God's word, we grow spiritually, and we grow in ministry to each other and to God's people. Strategies that help to improve our faith are prayer, as we get more comfortable praying to God. When difficult situations arise, we become more attuned to His voice and know He only wants the best for us, even if what we receive is not what we expected. We can trust His plans to give us hope and a future, and not to harm us. Reading God's word. Reading the Bible helps us to be even more attuned to God's voice and His promises. Someone once said, "Leaders must be readers." As we read God's word, we become more equipped to be better disciples. To encourage our friends to grow their faith. We can encourage them to get baptized if they are ready to take that step, and evangelize to them in a way that they can understand. Praying together. We can invite them to church if it's okay with their parents, by encouraging them to walk together in prayer and Bible study, or by having a mentor to help clarify things and to guide them through their Christian journey. These were answers to our faith-based questions. We believe that faith is important in the life of a Christian because as it is, faith and the support of people who have faith is what brings us through when faced with difficult situations and even in good times. Knowing that we believe and trust in God who loves us so deeply. Faith, however, works well with another factor, love. Serving one another humbly in love and through the Spirit, having faith in God's promises helps sustain us on our Christian journey. We often hear that we should walk by faith and not by sight. This means an implicit trust that God will never leave us or forsake us or lead us astray. We are reminded that faith, the size of a mustard seed, can move mountains. So I leave you with this. What does faith stand for? F. For. A. Anything. I. Impossible. T. Trust. H. Him. For anything impossible, trust Him. Amen.
You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand. Thank you.
God, by whom the meek are guided in judgment, and light rises up in darkness for the godly, grant us, in all our doubts and uncertainties, the grace to ask what you would have us to do, that the spirit of wisdom may save us from all false choices, and that in your light we may see light, and in your straight path we may not stumble, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Grant to your servants, O God, to be set on fire with your love, to be strengthened by your power, to be illuminated by your spirit, to be filled with your grace, and to move on with your help, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do have a restful night. Feel my